What's up, Skate fam? David Lalliette from Double D here to bring you another lesson on the edges and why edges are so important to skating. You may have seen my most recent video, in which I break down the skate edge's functionality into 6 parts. If not, I left a link for you in the description below. Understanding how your edges work is probably the most important part of learning to skate, which is why my personal skating habits involve a lot of time training them and learning to be better in tune with how they work in each skate that I use. There are a million different moves you can learn to do in skates, but how can someone possibly learn to do the more advanced ones if they don't have control of the skate's simpler functions? I love to toy around and do whatever feels good as much as the next guy, but what if I told you doing that will feel even better if you have a greater foundational understanding of the mechanics involved in basic skating? Essentially, you only really begin to manipulate and break the rules once you have a solid understanding of what they are and how they work. As I said before, slow and controlled motions pave the way for smooth, quick, and powerful motions. Manipulating your edges has a lot to do with how skilled you are at shifting between points of balance in your feet. The smoother you can roll your balance back and forth between the heels and toes, the better your forward and backward transitions will be. Turning also relies on weight shifting, as you are pressing in your skates on the inside or outside edges when turning. Now to the learning process. I once read a book called Power Skating by figure skater / hockey coach Laura Stamm, where Stamm discussed the importance of being familiar with the learning process. In this section, she says something to the effect of, "Practice does not make perfect. Perfect practice makes perfect," emphasizing the importance of doing things the right way and utilizing the full range of motion in every exercise you do. Like Ms. Stamm, I believe that learning things in the most effective way possible and then doing them over and over and over again is what makes the difference between a skater who just survives and a skater who thrives. Being smooth and in control of every element in motion depends on the basic habit of drill repetition, after spending much time slowly perfecting how each drill works. Learning things in the proper order. A mistake many new skaters make is trying to learn how to skate as fast as possible right out of the gate. Everyone wants to get rolling and go as fast as they can, and why wouldn't you? It's fun to go fast. The problem is that learning how to stop is more important as a beginning skill than learning how to go fast. You wouldn't get in a car that had a hidden brake, drive full speed down the interstate, and hope you can search around and find the brake before you need to stop, would you? That's exactly what you're doing if you skate fast without a solid method of stopping just as fast. Before you go fast, learn an effective stopping method. Then practice the motion slowly, over and over, taking time to feel your edges and familiarize yourself with the trick. Then add some conviction to your movements. Once you have the ability to execute your stop quickly and effectively, do it over and over in different situations at different speeds. This is how you make a stop second nature. Only then will your stops truly be smooth, quick, and powerful. But stopping is just one example of how to apply this philosophy when training the edges. Any move you want to master can be yours with this simple formula. Just make sure you take your time. Don't expect to have anything mastered in one day. Learn to enjoy the process of being on your skates and trying new things. As the old saying goes, Rome wasn't built in a day. So strap your skates on and build your foundation in them one step at a time. Train your edges and try to be patient with yourself. And as a last note, I leave you with my favorite quote from Bruce Lee. Thanks for skating with me today, and I'll see you the next time I lace up.